Alright, what's up everyone, I'm Faloki, and today we're going to be taking a look at a recap of the Week 9 matchup between the now 6-2 Seattle Seahawks and the 7-2 Buffalo Bills. In this Week 9 matchup, the Seahawks picked up their second loss of the season, and honestly, this is a well-deserved loss. We played horrible on both sides of the football. Russell Wilson turned the ball over a lot, our defense couldn't make a stop to save their life. And honestly, we deserve to lose this game. This is definitely the worst loss we've had so far, much worse than the Cardinals game, and it's probably going to be the worst overall when it's all said and done. When it comes to the stats, honestly, if you look at the box score, it looks a lot less bad than it actually was. Russell Wilson completed 28 of his 41 attempts for 390 yards, 2 touchdowns, 2 interceptions, and he was sacked 5 times. Josh Allen, on the other hand, completed 31 of his 38 attempts for 415 yards, 3 touchdowns, and no interceptions. He was sacked 7 times, though. When it came to the run game, neither team did well whatsoever. They both had 2 touchdowns, but overall a very inefficient day when it comes to yards per carry. On the defensive side for the Seahawks, surprisingly enough, we actually had 7 sacks today. Bobby Wagner, KJ Wright, and new acquisition Carlos Dunlap all had a sack. Jamal Adams coming back from injury had a sack and a half, and Jaron Reed came out and got 2.5 sacks. So overall, I mean, decent day for us when it came to the actual pass rush. For the first time in what feels like forever, we've actually had a game with more than like 2 sacks. But it really wasn't enough. Our defense did not play good whatsoever when it came to the coverage. So, you know, the pass rush, we had 7 good plays. We had 7 sacks, but other than that, really no good plays for our defense whatsoever. Although the box score itself doesn't look horrible for the Seahawks, you know, 34-44 game, not a good defensive game for either team. You know, only a 10-point difference, not horrible. The total yards for each team were basically the same. Not too big of a difference in time of possession. When you watch the actual game, it does not reflect whatsoever what the box score said. This game was an absolutely horrendous game for both sides. The defense just could not get a stop. Our coverage was lackluster at best. And Russell Wilson, he turned the ball over way too much. One thing I want to say before I get into basically the takeaways and all the negatives that I have for this game on the Seahawks side, I want to give credit to the Bills. They played a really good game. Their defense came out and played well. I said that we had to take care of the ball, watch the ball security. They got 2 strip sacks on Russell Wilson. They got 2 interceptions on Russell Wilson. Just some really good plays defensively. They came out, they played good defense. They had a really good offensive start. They kind of realized that we can't cover the pass whatsoever. I'm pretty sure they passed the ball like 15 plays and ran the ball like twice to start the game. So, you know, they just went straight in to kill us in the passing game, and it worked to perfection for them. So honestly, big credit to the Bills. Credit to Josh Allen. He played really well today. So, I mean, this was a really good game by the Bills, but honestly, I think the main thing is this was a horrible game for the Seahawks. And when it comes to horrible games, the first thing I want to talk about here is the defense. And yet again, another loss that really shows how reliant we are on Russell Wilson completely carrying this team. Our defense, with Jamal Adams back, with Carlos Dunlap, you know, we got some talent. But we just cannot play defense to save our life. We're playing soft zone where we're just letting up like 10, 15 yard catches with no coverage whatsoever. We just let them catch it and then tackle them once they get the ball. And by that point, you know, they're just going to get free first downs. They're getting past the midway line every single time. So they're either getting a field goal or a touchdown almost every single time unless we find a way to get a turnover, which we didn't this game. And honestly, I'm not too big into the knowledge of defensive schemes and stuff like that. But man, I'm not a big fan either of calling for someone to be fired, but Ken Norton Jr., his job security has to be on the line because we have played absolutely horrendous. We have so much talent. We have Jamal Adams, Quandre Diggs. We don't have Shaquille Griffin right now because he's injured, but we still have Quentin Dunbar. Our corners are fine. We have Bobby Wagner, KJ Wright. We have Jordan Brooks. We've got a good defensive line now that we have Carlos Dunlap. Puna Ford did really well. Jaron Reed did pretty well. You know, we have a really talented team. But it just, something is not right, and it has to be the play calling, because those soft zones that we play are just absolutely atrocious. Really, you know, as a fan, I watched the game, and we went down 17-0 early on in the second quarter, and at that point, I already knew we lost the game. Because no matter how good Russell Wilson did, if he picked it up from that point and scored every single drive, our defense would not be able to stop the Bills from scoring 3 times to allow us to get the actual comeback that we needed. I had no confidence in our defense whatsoever because every time we went out there on defense, they were just getting picked apart because they did not play any man coverage. We're not a team built for man. We're a team built for zone, obviously, because that's kind of how our defense has been built throughout the last few years. But there has to be a change. I think Ken Norton Jr.'s job security is definitely on the line, and I don't like firing people mid-season just to kind of appease the fans, but my God, there needs to be a change. With how much talent we have, to be this bad on defense, we have to do something different. And honestly, I really don't see many other changes that we can make except for a coaching change and a scheme change and a game planning change for the defense. You know, one of the main reasons why I have a problem with our defense being horrible is not because it makes us lose games and it really doesn't allow us to win games dominantly. It's because I know how good we were, and it's just so disappointing because the Legion of Boom days, you know, every single time our team goes onto the field to play defense and they get absolutely cooked, I look right over here and I see this thing right over here, this right here, this ball. The Seahawks, you know, they're kind of accomplishment ball, you know, they have their championship, they have a couple of their NFC championships. This just reminds me every single time I look at it is, this was the last time our defense was good. The last time our defense really was able to be the strong suit of this team was like a year after we went to the Super Bowl and threw it on the 1 yard line and got intercepted. That was the last time our defense was really good. And it's just so disappointing because I know how nice it is to have a really good defense. You know, Russell Wilson, he wasn't the elite quarterback that he is now. He wasn't absolutely amazing like he is now. But our defense could actually be relied on to get stops. You know, if Russell Wilson threw an interception, oh darn, guess we'll just have to get a three and out like we always do because we have the Legion of Boom, one of the best defenses in the league. But now it's at the point where, oh man, you know, Michael Dixon, amazing punt. We just pinned him inside the 1 yard line. They're going to go get a 99-yard touchdown. It's guaranteed, you know. It's just so disappointing having a bad defense because I know how nice it is to have a really good defense. And, you know, just the difference of watching it is just so disheartening because, you know, Russell Wilson, you kind of saw, he never really got into a rhythm last game or this game. And it just, you kind of knew we were going to lose because Russell Wilson, he wasn't really cooking. He wasn't clicking on all cylinders like he normally is. He had a pretty bad game. And by pretty bad, I mean an absolutely horrible game for his standards. And it really led to us getting completely destroyed. And that brings me to the offense. Now, of course, the offense runs through Russell Wilson, especially with Chris Carson and Carlos Hyde out. It really has forced us to be a one-dimensional team. And that is a problem because, you know, earlier on in the season, when we had Chris Carson and Carlos Hyde in, they were still a threat to be able to run the ball. Now the Seahawks aren't a threat whatsoever, really. We're forced into being one-dimensional. You know, early on in the season, we could be one-dimensional. We could let Russell Wilson cook and do whatever he wanted because we at least had the threat of running the ball so we could do a play action and teams would actually be kind of scared. But now that we're literally running the ball with Travis Homer and he's getting negative 4 yards like three times in a row, it's not going to work. We can't have any threat of the run game, so we're just forced into being one-dimensional. Russell Wilson throwing 41 passes, that doesn't happen too much. Obviously, we're coming from behind most of the game, if not all of the game, actually. And it's just the fact that we don't have a running game that can get us yards. Like, DJ Dallas, I love the guy. Travis Homer, one of the best pass protectors we have on the team, and that includes some of our offensive line. It's just, we cannot use those two players to, you know, force the ball down the defense's throat to just, you know, push the ball forward and kind of get those tough yards. Chris Carson, you hand him the ball, maybe he'll get tackled behind the line of scrimmage every now and then, but if the gap closes, he's forcing his way for at least 3-4 yards. He is getting those yards no matter what. But someone like Travis Homer, who's a very good pass protector, good pass catcher, he's just not a power back that can really force those yards. He gets tackled behind the line of scrimmage and he kind of just goes down. And I mean, the offensive line, they've been playing pretty well this season. I'm not going to lie. The offensive line, surprisingly enough, has been a very good part of our team. That's something that I did not expect whatsoever going into the season. I was really hoping for it with all the changes that we had. Maybe we'll see some improvement. And we really did. I mean, honestly, we did. We saw the offensive line get a lot better. They're now average instead of like the worst in the league. That's nice to see. This was the highest amount of sacks that we've given up in a game this season, and it was only 5. I'm pretty sure last year that was probably one of the best games we had all season. But I mean, overall, I mean, our offensive line did not do good today. They've done good the whole entire season, but today they let Russell Wilson get hit 16 times. You don't let your star elite, just superstar quarterback get hit 16 times. You don't allow that happen. Basically, you know, Russell Wilson, it seemed like every single time he was throwing the ball, he was getting hit after the play or getting hit as he was throwing it, or he was at least completely pressured, just being rushed without much, you know, blocking. He had a couple good ones where the blocking was completely perfect, and that led to some touchdowns, some really good plays for the Seahawks, but just the offensive line did not look good. And there was a lot of key moments where the offensive line let up a huge play that really just stopped any momentum we had. Dwan Brown was real upset on the sideline multiple times. And I mean, he came back and had a really nice block for a rushing touchdown for DJ Dallas. But overall, a really weak game for the offensive line. Just did not look like it has been the entirety of the season so far. And now this brings me to Russell Wilson. And honestly, I love the guy. I mean, ever since he got drafted by us, he was an underdog, third round pick, too short to play in the NFL, you know. And then he came in, started his first game. He has started every single game of his career so far. He has been consistent. He has been reliable. He doesn't get injured. He's just an insanely talented, insanely smart player. And honestly, I'm so glad we have him on the team, because with how bad our defense has been recently in recent years, how bad our offensive line has been in recent years, and even this year, they're not amazing. They're pretty decent compared to what they were before, but they're still not a great offensive line. If we had any other quarterback on this team, I don't think they're doing anywhere near as good as Russell Wilson is. No NFL quarterback other than Russell Wilson is going to be putting up MVP-type stats, historic stats, on the team that we have now. Patrick Mahomes, insanely talented. Kyler Murray, insanely talented. Kyler Murray is really the only guy that I think could possibly do it, because he's used to having a bad offensive line. But you put Patrick Mahomes on the Seahawks right now, he is not doing good whatsoever, because Patrick Mahomes, one of the greatest things he has for him is his offensive line being one of the best in the league. Russell Wilson dealing with a horrible offensive line for quite a while. And I mean, this year is probably the best he's had in the last 4 or 5 years. Just, he is insanely talented. But today was a really bad day for him. Russell Wilson, like in the Cardinals game, did not play particularly well. He had too many turnovers, not enough touchdowns. You know, he had two passing touchdowns, he had a rushing touchdown, but he threw two interceptions, and he had two fumbles. And that's just inexcusable for a quarterback of this star talent, someone so talented as Russell Wilson. I love the guy. I'm not going to completely dog on him and just completely just dogpile onto him and just hate on him because he did bad one game. You know, he did bad against the Cardinals, but at least he equaled out the touchdown to turnover ratio. But this game, he did not. 3 touchdowns to 4 total turnovers. Just a really bad game for him. And he knows this. He knows he had a bad game. Kind of like the Cardinals game. He took responsibility, really. And he knows that this is the game that could have been won. With less mistakes, could have easily been won. Maybe if, instead of throwing those turnovers, he threw the ball away a couple times. Instead of letting the ball get fumbled, he just, you know, held the ball and made sure that it stayed protected. Maybe we could have possibly just barely scratched out a win. Who knows? But it didn't happen. 4 turnovers is not good whatsoever. I think Russell Wilson, I mean, it just seems like he doesn't play well against other MVP candidates. Josh Allen was an MVP candidate earlier on in the season. Kyler Murray is some guy that's being talked as an MVP guy now. And honestly, those are the two worst games Russell Wilson has had, where he's been completely outperformed by those quarterbacks that are also in the MVP race. And it really sucks to see, because you kind of see, although he is having a historic start to the season, you kind of see the MVP slowly just getting taken away from him every single time they lose, because, you know, they love him when he's doing amazing, but the second he has a bad game, everyone will turn on him and just completely dogpile onto him and hate him because, you know, too many turnovers. I think this is just a game, just one game out of the entire season. I think next week we'll come back and do pretty well against the Rams, but I mean, I just hope for Russell Wilson's sake that he can come back and just, you know, he's had 2 pretty bad games. The Cardinals game and the Bills game were real bad. He had a good game in between them against the 49ers, but those 2 games, pretty close succession, not good whatsoever for Russell Wilson. Finally, before we end the video, I wanted to focus on just something that Pete Carroll said after the game. And of course, this is what Pete Carroll should be saying, because you want to keep team chemistry. You don't want to start just absolutely killing the locker room and making players hate each other. But this is what he said. We're going to hang together. We're not going to point fingers. We're not going to be calling anybody out. We're going to stay together, stay tight, and turn it back around again. Now, like I said, this is exactly what Pete Carroll should be saying as a coach. You don't want to turn the players against you. You don't want to turn the players against each other. You want to keep the teammate chemistry. But as a fan, I am pointing the finger at the defense. Russell Wilson didn't play good whatsoever this game, but even the games that he does play well, the games early on in the season, the man was throwing 5 touchdowns in games with 0 interceptions, just absolutely playing out of his mind, and it's still coming down to the last play of the game. How do we let that happen? You know, of course, you can't point the finger when you're within the organization because you're going to kill teammate chemistry. But my God, us as fans can point the finger at the defense. This game, we can kind of point the finger somewhat at Russell Wilson, but it's still mainly the defense. This entire season, we have had the worst defense in history. We have to do better. How are we going to be a Super Bowl team with the worst passing defense and worst total yardage defense in history? How are we going to be able to do anything like that? It just, there needs to be changes. I don't want to call for the firing of Ken Norton Jr., but my God, does it seem like it might be the best option right now. Just try something new. I'm not a big fan of firing the head coach like, you know, the Falcons did or, you know, the Texans did. I don't think any real change comes from that, putting an interim head coach in, because you're not really changing anything when it comes to actually playing the game. You're really just appeasing the fans. But I mean, defensive coordinator, I think we could actually make a change and maybe actually get better, because we have super talented players. It's not the personnel that's the problem. It is definitely the way that we're playing defense, the scheme, the game plan. That is the problem that we're having. And I mean, I hate to try to call for the firing of someone. I don't want anyone to lose their jobs, but it just seems as a fan like we need to make a change on defense, and it just hasn't happened in 8 games. Everyone knew this, the defense was a problem. At week 2, we knew it was a problem, but nothing has changed. It's looked the exact same. Now we're not giving up the huge deep ball plays, which we actually gave up a few today, but we're just giving up easy underneath passes. Like, maybe you stopped one problem, but you have to stop every problem that you possibly can. You can't just play a soft zone, let a dude catch the ball 13 yards down the field, get a free first down, and then tackle him, and probably have a 50% chance of missing the tackle and letting him go for another 10 yards. It just does not work. Our defense is not working. We need to make a change. If that's firing Ken Norton, fine. I'm fine with it. If that's Ken Norton deciding he wants to play a different defense, fine. I'm fine with it. We need some type of change on the defense. I don't want to see us continue to play this soft zone where we really don't play any coverage. We just tackle people after they get a first down, and we let teams either slowly march down the field or we give up a huge touchdown. There's really no in between. We really don't have a dominant defensive game. Yes, the 49ers game, but they are basically a second string, third string team because their entire team is injured. So I don't really think that that counts. I mean, today it really showed the Bills were the better team today. The Bills were the better defense. Josh Allen played as the better quarterback today. Honestly, horrible game for the Seahawks today. I'm glad that we lost. I love when we lose games like this, because if we win this game of our defense playing absolutely atrocious, then we have somewhat of an excuse of, hey, look, the defense played absolutely horribly, but we won the game. No, we didn't win the game. Our defense played horribly. They need to be held accountable. We need to make a change, and it's something that I don't think is going to happen, disappointingly enough. I don't think we're going to be making a change. I think Ken Norton is probably going to keep his job for the rest of the season, and he's probably going to be playing the same defense the rest of the season, and we're just going to have a horrible defense with Russell Wilson either completely carrying us in games or not being able to do enough to carry us, and we lose games. That's how it's going to be for the rest of the season. I believe most likely that's going to be the case, and it's very disappointing. Overall, this was just a really bad game for both the offense and the defense. The special teams did fine. Michael Dixon, he had a crazy good punt. Jason Myers, he made his field goals. That's really all that we ask of him. Offensively, Russell Wilson didn't play great. He played pretty poorly. Our run game cannot get going without Chris Carson. And, I mean, DK Metcalf, he made some plays. Jacob Hollister came out and made some plays. But just overall, offense didn't play well. And defensively, my God, we played so bad. Somehow our pass rush had 7 sacks. That's probably the best that it's been in, what, the last 3 years in a single game? I don't know, but probably. But our coverage is just non-existent, man. Like, it was just so obvious. The Bills were just killing us because they'd pass the ball like 10, 12 yards. There'd be no one near him. They may get a tackle. You know, they're playing a soft zone, letting him catch the ball and then tackling him. But then, you know, you miss the tackle, you left like a 25 extra yards. It's just not good. It's not fun to watch this defense because you just kind of expect it at this point. You expect the defense to just get absolutely cooked, absolutely torched every single game. It's not fun. You know, even the 49ers game, we played so good for 3 quarters, and then we let Nick Mullins come in and score 3 touchdowns. How do we let that happen? Why does our defense have to play so poorly every single game? You know, the day that we play a talented team and our defense comes out and plays insanely well for 4 quarters is the day the world ends. I don't think it's going to happen this season without a change in the coaching or the scheme or something. Ken Norton, I mean, I'm not going to call to fire the guy because, I mean, I've seen a lot of people doing it already. I mean, I think they've already gotten the message, but it just seems like there needs to be a change. I don't think it's the personnel on the defensive side of the football. We have great players. We have insanely talented players. They just are not getting the opportunities to show their talent because I believe the scheme that they're in, this weird soft zone that we love to play of not actually guarding anyone and just tackling them after they catch the ball, it doesn't work. We let teams get past the midfield line and they just are going to either score a field goal or a touchdown, or we're going to somehow get a lucky interception. There's no other option. We really cannot get stops. Maybe once a game we'll get a three and out, but just not consistently enough will we be able to play defense. I think that there needs to be a change on the defensive side. I think we have a lot of talent. I just think the scheme and the game plan and how our defense is actually played is just not using our players to the best of their abilities. But with that, that's going to do it for this video. I'm sorry that this was just kind of me rambling and me just completely just hating on the Seahawks team, but this is really just all I got from the game. I don't care about what the stats are. I don't care about the play-by-play. You watched the game. You saw how this game went. This was an atrocious game, no matter which way you look at it. If you look at the offensive side, 4 turnovers for Russell Wilson, not good by any means. Look at the defensive side, we played no defense really. Our pass rush, okay, we did good, but those 7 sacks were about the 7 only good plays we had on defense. So I'm really not too happy about it, honestly. Cool, we can get 7 sacks when we get absolutely dominated by a team that, honestly, I think I predicted we lose to them, but I don't think they should be beating us like this. And I mean, even if Russell Wilson threw 5 touchdowns, no interceptions, I still think our defense is going to allow like 45 points no matter what, and we're going to lose the game. I mean, this is just a game that we were destined to lose. Just in the beginning of the second quarter, once we went down 17-0, you knew we were going to lose this game. Our defense is not going to be able to get enough stops to let us come back down from 3-score deficit. But, you know, like I said, that's going to do it for this video. Let me know down below what you thought about this game. You've heard what I thought about it. I am not a big fan of how the team's been playing on the defensive side. Russell Wilson, he's either carrying the team to victory or he has an off game and we lose by a ton. And overall, just a disappointing game. Leave a like if you enjoyed. Subscribe if you're new. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.